Sounds like this is a big part of this conversation we're talking about. If you kind of have to reprogram your kind of the family's understanding, yes, of these terms, that might, because if we go into this stage and we haven't talked about it, gosh, that hospice is exactly what you said. It kind of has a negative, giving up kind of a feel to it.
And people may assume hospice equals cancer diagnosis too. A lot of times that's, mm-hmm, associated. Mm-hmm. One of the really unique and good parts of hospice and palliative care is the collaborative practice between your physician, your social worker or case manager, the nurse, physical needs, pharmacist, it's a whole team effort, nutrition, clergy, pastoral care, not just through those days, but also after and through the grieving process can, mm-hmm, be very significantly helpful for the family.
Right. Hospice generally stays in contact with the family for a year following the death of the patient, which is a really brilliant thing that they do. I know that after my grandmother died and was in hospice, I really appreciated getting those letters in the mail. And they came just at the right time, I always felt like. Mm-hmm. And it was just a reminder that someone knew I was grieving. It didn't end at my 3 days bereavement leave at work, right? Things still hurt 6 months later. Things were still hurting at 9 months. And things were still hurting at 12 months when I stopped getting the letters. But they told me that that was okay and that was normal. And they really normalized the grieving process, which I think is a real added benefit of hospice that it offers to families.
Did you have all the conversations you wanted to and that you thought, and I don't mean, beyond the personal conversation, but sure, in terms of the things we're talking about here, had you covered all those bases?
Oh, absolutely. My grandmother and I did nothing but talk about death. That was kind of her favorite thing to talk about. So we were, now you understand why I like talking about death with everyone. And I was her power of attorney. So I also knew all of her wishes, her final wishes, and it was a truly incredible experience when she did have a fall and a traumatic brain injury to be able to act on her behalf. It made me feel like it was the biggest sort of blessing that I could give to her at the end of her life to make a decision that she would have made for herself.